start again from the beginning.
Yeah.
Just do it like Moses.
Thank you.
that you can hold me.
Four times. Keep it.
Well, in my church we do it. One, two, three, four. One, ready, sing.
Former boys and former choir boys. came from all over the country to attend this funeral. And as a grave site, former choir boy sang the beautiful song made it here, a cappella, which is what we are about. At that time, he was pastor at West Point St. Aloysius Parish. Now I'm going to introduce the
grave poster.
Okay, Mr. DeVille, we're ready.
Okay.
Monsignor Francis Schmidt, lifetime honorary chaplain, will now lead us in prayer. Father Schmidt.
Father in heaven, creator of all, you ordered the earth to breathe forth life and crowned its goodness by creating the family of man. Guide and protect and love our Boystown family and all our individual families, that we may live in peace and gratitude for your gifts. Bless this meeting, bless this food, and make us ever worthy of your love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. together, let us ask the Lord to come among us, to place his loving, healing, forgiving, encouraging hand upon each of us. Without you, Lord Jesus, we can do nothing. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the life. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you reveal to us your Father's love. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory.
Sweep away the innocent with the guilty.
said, "Let not my Lord go with patience. If I go on, what if only 30 are found there?" He replied, "I will forbear doing it if I can find the 30 there." Still he went on, "Since I have thus dared to speak to my Lord, what if there are no more than 20? I will not destroy it," he answered, "for the sake of the 20. But still persisted, "Please, let not my Lord grow angry if I speak up this last time. What if there are at least 10? For the sake of those 10, he replied, "I will not destroy it." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks for your name.
Lord, Lord, I call for help. You answer.
we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your Father, I give you peace. My peace I give you. Look not upon our sinfulness and destruction, but look upon the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus be in the hearts of every one of you.
And also in
the spirit and brothers and sisters in the Lord Jesus.
Thank you. to us a classification of
Thank you. Are you Father Flanagan?
Yes, my boy.
Father, I'm Johnny Walsh. We come from Chicago. We ain't got a home or nobody. Will you take us? Can we come in?
Let us sit down. You must be tired. Have you no father or mother?
Well, my mother, she died last year. And my father, well, I guess he just didn't want me because he went away. I tried to take care of myself, but it just didn't work out so good. And then one of the fellas, he told me about you. He said if a fellow didn't have a friend, if he could just get to you, well, you will take us, won't you, Father? We've come so far. There's just no place to go.
Have you had any dinner, Johnny?
No, Father.
Well, we're going to get something to eat right away. And a bed to sleep on. And tomorrow you're going to see the rest of the boys.
Do you mean you're going to take us?
Of course, my boy.
You're going to take us?
Sure.
Oh, thanks, Father.
We all know the world is full of boys who, through ignorance, neglect, and perhaps thoughtlessness, have violated the laws of God and man. It is also true that these problem boys have presented and still are presenting a grave situation in our social order, notwithstanding the fact that our country is singularly blessed with facilities for producing good citizens. If the future of our country is to be secure from dangerous enemies from within, parents and guardians of children must become more conscious of the responsibilities which God has placed upon them. We must become more virtuous in our own lives, that we may teach more effectively the lesson of proper citizenship by example as well as instruction. Kindness and love will open the heart of any problem boy. That heart will melt within the warmth of the sunshine of love. I have really never found a boy who wanted to be bad.